Ovarian cancer is a relatively rare disease. Any one patient's lifetime risk is about 1.7%. There are certain families that pass on a gene that increases their risk of developing ovarian cancer. The most common is BRCA, which also puts patients at higher risk of breast cancer. Ovarian cancer itself usually does not give symptoms that are obvious in the earliest stages. The most common symptoms associated with ovarian cancer are a decreased appetite, bloating, persistent heartburn, pressure in the pelvis that might give some urinary complaints, that might give some general discomfort or pain. Unfortunately, all these symptoms are very nonspecific.
For ovarian cancer, we do know that it's very important that women are treated by gynecologic oncologists because it's different than what maybe a general surgeon would do or a general OBGYN. And so, you know, if they need radical surgery, and that includes, you know, a hysterectomy or removal of the ovaries, but also sometimes includes removing the spleen, the omentum, the diaphragm, doing lymph node sampling, doing bowel surgery. So we do everything in the abdomen that needs to be done.
For patients who are diagnosed in stage one or stage two, cure rates are pretty high with surgery and usually chemotherapy. For patients who are diagnosed in stage three or four, they also require surgery and chemotherapy. Whether we do surgery first or chemotherapy first might depend on where the disease is and what the patient's overall health is, but generally it's a combination of surgery and chemotherapy. That chemotherapy journey is usually on the order of about 5 months. It's usually outpatient chemotherapy to where a patient comes in, has labs checked, meets with a physician to talk about how they're doing, and if their labs are okay, get chemotherapy over the course of about 4 or 5 hours and are able to go home that same day.
It's really overwhelming to get a cancer diagnosis. And so, you know, as soon as I say you may have cancer or you have cancer, people really have a hard time remembering anything else I say at that moment. So we make sure we give people a lot of written information. I ask everyone to keep a notebook and write things down as they get them so that when the next time we talk, either on the phone or in person, that they can go through what they want. It's really important to get to know the patient, their whole family, so that you can tailor the treatments that most impact them.